it led me where I was looking for different avenues. And then, you know, Sir James moves down the street from me. And his cousin is Dr. Dre. And so he's the only one on our street with turntables. This is Jinx, turntables with, you know, he bringing cardboard outside. He's spinning on his head and shit. And we like, we down the street looking like, what's up with this dude? You know, we didn't know about breaking and all that shit. Mm. But he was graffiti. He just was a B-boy. You know, he was the, you know, the hip-hop guru on the street. So I started to go down there and hang with him because I used to go out with his sister. So I just go hang with him.
What age was this?
13, 14, 15. And people would trip. They'd be like, man, why you going out to hang that weirdo, man? I'd be like, man. I said, you be doing some dope shit in that room, man. I start rhyming, and me and him, you know, we just start working. He would put on beats. He would help me rhyme on beat because I didn't have no beats. I was just a cappella, you know what I'm saying? So helped me. Then then Dre came through one day and heard me rhyme. And Dre kind of took me under his wing because him and Jinx, I mean, Jinx would always want to compete with him. Mm-hmm. Jinx was like, I'm a better DJ than you, nigga. I'm a better, I do better beats. I do better everything. Dre would be like, come on, man. It's, you know, start me out with that. But I would be, you know, more helpful. You know what I'm saying? I was like, what y'all working on as the wrecking crew? You know what I'm saying? Like, let me write something for y'all. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I was like trying to get in. And I wrote something for him and it was a hit. Mm-hmm. We wrote it together, me and Dre. And it was a hit. And they had slow jam hits like Turn Off the Lights and shit. But this was actually a hit that was moving. They was playing all day on the radio, so.
Yeah, I know. Y'all seen the movie. Yeah, 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 blah, blah, blah. Show me a side of the movie where Dr. Dre and Ice Cube talked about how they met. Oh, that's right. They didn't do that. They just jumped right to it. So for those of y'all that are really interested in the topic of conversation, I appreciate y'all. Welcome to the pond. Hope you like this video. Hit like, hit share, comment, follow, subscribe. All that stuff helps the algorithm. For those of y'all that want to come here and talk shit like, we already know that, then why are you watching? Leave right now. I don't care if folks with my watch time. Get the fuck out. I don't like you. Your mom should have spit you on the floor.
My ducks. My swans, welcome to the pond.
My name is Dorian from group82university.com, and right here, we got Ice Cube talking about how he met Dr. Dre. I'm going to give you three things you should really take away from this clip. First of all out to All the Smoke. Shout out to Matt Barnes. Shout out to Steven Jackson. You know, probably my favorite podcast out. I love damn near every guest they've had on there. This is a great episode, by the way. The first thing that you need to take away from this is you need to not listen to outsiders. Ice Cube was genuinely interested in what Sir Jinx was doing. Sir Jinx was being a New York B-boy in Compton, California in the mid-80s. Something that is just not going to be accepted in any way, shape, or form. You know, imagine somebody walking around with a rake hanging out of their ass and they want to play basketball with you. Like, bro, you're not hooping with us. That's just not accepted. You're weird. All right. This is how people was looking at B-boys in the 80s like that. That analogy is kind of funny. You know, Ice Cube didn't listen to the people in the neighborhood that was saying, like, man, why are you hanging out with him? Woo-dee-woo. He was like, man, what's going on in that house is dope. And that's some things you gotta be. You can't be such a fucking groupie. You can't be such a clout chaser. You can't be so dependent on other people's opinions. You gotta want to do the shit for you. And when you follow your heart and do what you truly want to do, that's when everything starts aligning. Nobody knows your path but you. Only you. So go with what's in your heart, because that's what you're supposed to be doing. That's your destiny. Number two, need to be a student. Being a student is how I've been able to do anything in my life. School doesn't teach us how to be a student. School teaches us how to take orders and regurgitate useless information. It's sad we're in school that long and we get called a student for that many years, decades, and we really don't know how to learn. Once you get out of school and you have to teach yourself things, that's when you become a true student. And Ice Cube wasn't going to learn about B-boy history or New York rap history from school or from an encyclopedia or from some videos. He had to learn from his peer, which is Sir Jinx. And think about the level of security Ice Cube had in himself to learn from one of his peers. Think about whenever you try to teach one of your peers something. You got friends right now that if you try to spit some game to them, they're not going to listen to you. But if a stranger says the exact same thing you're saying, they're going to listen to that stranger. Because some people have this block inside their head that anyone inside their circle can't achieve anything great or anything bigger than than what they can achieve. And because so many people are low achievers, they don't believe in themselves. Even if you're a moderately successful achiever, they want to pull you down. But they'll listen to strangers with no regard. And so this is what Ice Cube did. He listened to a stranger who was actually his friend. Eventually became Sir Jinx, which allowed him to get introduced to the producer that would change his life. The third thing that I want you to take away from this is you need to be open to like-minded people. Ice Cube and Dr. Dre were one of the same, and the fact that they were from the same area, around the same age, knew the same people, were into the same art, and had an intellectual curiosity about them. They were young, they were teenagers, they were kids, but they were open and respectful to each other's creative energy. And look what we got out of it. When you come across people who are like-minded as you, when you come across people who are going along the same journey as you, you have to give them a certain level of baseline respect, because they're doing things that you are doing, and you already been there and you know how difficult it is. There's a lot of people in this, I don't even know what you want to call what I do, but there's a lot of people who I don't like. I just don't. I don't like their energy. I don't like how they handle business. I don't like how they talk about stuff. I don't like their flip-floppiness. I don't like how fickle they are. I don't like them at all. But I do respect the fact that they're doing the same thing that I'm doing. A lot of them are doing things bigger than what I'm doing. And because of that, I will never completely 100% write them off. And when they win, I truly want them to win, because I know how difficult this is. A lot of y'all are so quick to tear somebody down, and it's so much easier for you to tear somebody down that you don't even know how to build someone up when you need to. You don't know how to give compliments. You don't know how to receive compliments. A lot of y'all don't want to give someone a compliment because you say, I don't want your head too big. Who are you to determine that? If somebody did something that's worthy of a compliment and you genuinely want to give it to them. Why would you stop that? Because that might accidentally give them some more confidence that makes them continue to go do more great things? Or maybe that confidence might cause them to trick themselves off and they reveal who they truly are. Both of those are win-win situations for you. So why are you being a fucking hater? A lot of y'all got hater energy, and y'all can see the way you write, the way you respond to the things I say in these videos. Everything I say in these videos, either glass half full or glass half empty. And a lot of you glass half empty motherfuckers ain't doing shit with your life, and you wonder why. Because bitch, you ain't never had a glass half full in your life, because you don't see it. Everything's half empty. Everything's negative. Everything's what if. Everything's a scam. You're a bitch. Ice Cube wasn't no bitch. Dr. Dre wasn't no bitch. And look at what they did. I'm not no bitch. Look at what I'm doing. People that's taking my class, they ain't no bitch. And look at what they doing. What are you doing? Nothing. Sitting there being a bitch. If you tired of being a bitch, you on Instagram, click them links up top. You on YouTube, click the links in the box, not the pond. Y'all stay true.
Group82University.com.